Ascended Masters Kuan Yin and Hilarion, January 6, 2016.
Channeled by Vanessa Priest, Ascended Master Kuan Yin.
Greetings, beloveds. I am Ascended Master Kuan Yin, with a special message for you today. This channel Vanessa, recently channeled a message for you all from the Atlanteans. As a member of the Galactic Federation of Light, I want to piggyback off their message and encourage you all toward the furthering of the Divine's plan for your planet and for creation. What can I do, you may wonder. Every one of you is a unique child of God with a spark of the love of the Creator within you that has the power to radiate that love forth to all whom you encounter during your day-to-day activities. Only you can radiate this love, for that is what you were made to do. Yes, you may have a career or job that you do, but let this not define you, for you truly are love embodied on this planet. The more you radiate love, the more mindfully you do this regardless of the day-to-day circumstances you find yourself in, the more light you anchor into Gaia. The more light that is anchored into Gaia, the more you are aiding in the shadow, revealing itself and coming to the surface. The more this occurs, the more the planet moves toward the light, the more justice will be meted out, and the dark loses more and more allies. This is significant. We the beings of the Galactic Federation of Light, cannot emphasize enough how important this is. You were told of the plan for our landing in the second week of March 2016, during the Atlantean January 4, 2016 message, yet there is more to say. The reason no specific date has been shared with you is because our arrival will not be an easy breezy one. Much to the contrary. The powers that be on your planet will use their clout with the mainstream media to fool the masses into believing that you are being invaded by hostile forces. We anticipate a conflict that could take up to 3 weeks to conclude. Now, this can change and we are actively engaged in working behind the scenes to avoid conflict of any kind which would net losses on both sides. It is not to frighten you that we tell you this. Much to the contrary. We seek to enlighten you as to what you can do to change this predicted outcome, live and breathe love, focus on peace, and seek your news from alternate media sources. This last is in particular necessary for those of you in Western cultures for your mainstream media is tainted. Love is the only thing that is real. All else is illusion. You've heard this before, yet, please, hear it again with the ears of your soul and feel it resonate throughout your being. We will prevail. Light will expose all shadow and transmute it once and for all. Your work in bringing this about will be commended. No one is too young, old, or any other label to aid in the victory of love and light. I, Kuan Yin, as an ascended master, would love to be able to bring you a message full of love, joy, peace, and yes, rainbows. Yet we will not sugarcoat the truth. You are important to the fulfillment of the promise of Earth. The promise of a new earth that will truly be a heaven, so we do you the courtesy of speaking truth to you in the hopes that you will see only the sunshine and rainbows within the message and nothing of the illusion. Remember, please, that any losses on any side is in alignment with the soul's commitment and with its consent for there are no exceptions to free will. On this note, let me speak of free will for a moment. You've often heard of the Divines, the Angels, and the Ascended Masters' commitment to non-interference with free will, but why is this hard for humans to grasp, you may ask. Well, this is because zero interference is a concept that is actually quite hard for the ego-having human to understand since, as a species you all tend to make a habit of putting your fingers in one another's pie, as it were. You dabble in each other's lives, telling one another what to think, how to act. What to wear, what's cool, what's not, etc. You yourselves do not practice zero interference, thus you do have a tendency to mistrust anyone who doesn't engage in these activities, labeling them as odd, weird, or not normal. Let the weird ones rule, we say. Practice non-judgment. Practice the art of simply being. Be in the moment. Let your thoughts and emotions run free. Yet speak only when you can improve the peace, perfection, and beauty of silence. Let your intuition be your guiding light in the days and weeks to come. Visualize the day that we will come, welcomed with love and open arms. Focus upon it and imbue it with the emotion of love. Partner with us in the law of attraction in manifesting a peaceful coming of us to Earth. And let us all look forward to the day that we will all enjoy a level of freedom and love heretofore unknown in this universe. Love and light, my dears. Namaste.
Ascended Master Hilarion.
I am Ascended Master Hilarion with a message of truth for you as well. I want to acknowledge that some of you will be getting your hopes up, as it were in anticipation of the coming of the Atlanteans in us, the Galactic Federation of Light, who are their allies. This is understandable, yet, we would caution you against any blind faith, even to us. Manifesting the precisely right moment in time for our coming has been long in coming, and we are actively encouraging you to focus your intentions to aid in supporting the predicted time frame of our landing. Your focused intentions will make a difference for the more humans on Gaia that focus on manifesting an end to the madness and darkness in existence on Earth. By praying for our coming, the more flexibility we will have in making any conflict short-lived, if one is necessary at all. Two roads diverge in the path before us, one of conflict and pain and suffering, if short-lived, and one of a surprise, virtual ambush whereby our fleet can simply appear and liberate humanity. We need more support for this latter eventuality to take form and become the future. As has been stated in other messages, Earth and the universe where she resides is a free will zone. The more you use your free will for the realization of the Divine's plan for your world, the more we can walk into positions of power and diffuse any potential situation before it arises. This means that though the Divine's plan is something that the people of Earth have effectively voted for, your focused intentions will smooth the way for its manifestation. You have the power to aid us. We are truly not your liberators, we are your allies in the battle for the Earth and her people to return to the love and light of the Divine. Do not assume that you will be trading one form of slavery for another. This will not happen. Look to what we will do in the hours and particularly days after our arrival for confirmation of this. You will know and experience more freedom than ever before. And we, your allies, will ensure that you are empowered. The Divine will come, eventually, but first, it's important that you learn your people's true history and be guided in the establishment of governance that will support, not repress your freedom. Our channel Vanessa has often thought that the experiment of free will, while a success, has led to the realization of the epic failure of self-governance. She has indicated to us that human nature appears to lend itself to greed, corruption, etc. While this has been true on Earth, self-governance is a talent that can be taught, and therefore learned. The solution is in taking the personality and thereby the values of a candidate into account. When I say values, I don't mean stance on political issues, I mean what does a person actually value? Honesty? Integrity? Idealism? If faced with conflicting issues, what stance would the person actually take? Vanessa has indicated to us that she feels that as a people in the United States, the masses take a lot on faith without doing enough vetting, or due diligence on candidates for political office. Where is the personality test? Where is the test that measures a presidential candidate's military intelligence quotient? Where are the interview-level questions that even people applying for entry-level positions get asked, such as, how does this position fit in with your 5-year plan for yourself? Why do you want this position? What are your top 3 strengths and weaknesses and how do you handle them? Too often candidates pit themselves against one another, trying to show some of who they are by showing the masses what they are not, thereby confusing the issue. It also seems as if the candidates agreed behind closed doors to split the pie of political issues down the middle in order to divide and conquer the populace. Ask the tough questions. If you live in the United States, put the candidates on the defensive at their appearances by demanding answers to the issues of most concern to you. Much will be revealed once we are among you and truthfully, the election in the US, if all goes according to plan, will be a complete non-issue. However, you must take personal responsibility for what is now, and what will occur through the power of your prayers and intentions. I want to encourage you to share your truth with others, regardless of whether they are able to receive or not, for they will on some level. It is time, light workers, to get involved if you haven't already, or on a deeper, more dedicated level, if you already have. I wish you peace and the brightest of blessings, my brothers and sisters. Namaste.